What is success? Success is when a toddler takes his first step and his parents are proud of him. Success is when a person who's 4 years old gets admission in a school and he or she takes his or her first step towards the schooling. Parents feel proud of him. Success is when in the 8th standard, the first choice of taking Hindi or Sanskrit is made and the student faces that choice graciously. Success is when during the 10th board examination, a student leaves all his worries, all his other work, all his recreational activities and focuses only and only on board's examination. Success is when in the 11th standard, a student chooses to take commerce or science. Success is when after 12th standard, student chooses to enroll himself into a professional examination. That worry, that jitter, that fear which are flown down the spinal cord of a student when he is filling that form of CMA foundation, that bold step, that confident step, that will to stand apart from the crowd is, according to me, success. Filling the examination form for both the groups and having the courage to give examination of both the groups and both the groups together, according to me, is success. And finally, to attain those three critical alphabets prefixed with your name, CMA, that is success. So guys, success is a journey and definitely not a destination. Today I have with me a success story, CMA Gauri Saxena, and I am having the same feeling as that parent whose son or daughter would have taken the first step. I am having same feelings because yes, I am the proud teacher of CMA Gauri Saxena. CMA Gauri Saxena attempted her inters and finals both in first attempt, both the groups given together, and she has qualified both the groups. Thank you so much, Gauri, for being part of our talk show and enlightening all the students about what are the strategies of giving both the groups together. So the biggest worry which these guys have is whether they want to give one group or both the groups. Because I know it's a lot of pressure, the time is less at this point in time, and they are not aware what to do, what not to do. And the last thing which they think of is to leave one of the groups, which according to me is not the best strategy to choose. So I would request CMA Gauri Saxena to tell all the audience, all the students, all the subscriber of this channel, all the future budding CMAs, what are the success stories and what are the secrets of your success, and what were the steps which you had followed to become a CMA, a professional. So first of all, congratulations, Gauri, on attaining this amazing milestone of your career. Please, we would like to hear from the horse's mouth. Guys, round of applause for Gauri, direct from the horse's mouth, the strategies to win both the groups together.
First of all, thank you, sir, for inviting me here to share my experience with the budding CMAs. Right after my schooling, when everyone was planning to how to enjoy their next three graduation years, roam over university lanes, enjoy their weekends at drooling cafes, I chose a professional course along with my graduation. I chose my coaching classes over their fests. I chose my weekend test series over their weekend trips. And as a result of my hard work, my teacher's hard work, my parents' hard work, and definitely God's grace, I am today standing in front of you here as CMA Gauri Saxena. Trust me, guys, it is the most beautiful feeling, that privilege to have a professional prefix before your name, CMA Gauri, that cannot be expressed in words. My teacher's efforts, my parents' efforts, sleepless nights, all are worth it. Now let's come to the point. I am today here to tell you the importance and strategy to how to crack CMA exams. First, let's come to the importance of giving both groups. As usual, like other students, get pressurized and time is running out of our hands, I was also about to give up. But then my teachers boosted me up that at least attend both groups. and I was mentally prepared to see that tag not completed in my result. But fortunately, I got an amazing set off, both in my intermediate as well as in my final. In my case, if I would have given a single group at one sitting, I would have definitely failed. This is the importance of giving both groups, that I cleared my intermediate as well as my final, both in first attempt. Now, the point is strategy. What I did, that I cleared my intermediate and final in first attempt. First of all, coachings, we all take coachings, and it is not necessary to take all the coachings. Take it as per your convenience. But you cannot afford to leave coaching, but you cannot afford to have coachings till the month of November. You can only do it till the month of October. Leave the coachings if they are not completed. Do your self-study. It is more important. And do your module. That is important. Do your module with coachings. Secondly, scanner in the month of revision. The month of revision, November. And the most important, which I think every student leaves, MTP. It has been uploaded by our institute on their website. Around 30 to 40% paper comes from MTP. You can check in this attempt, you can check previous attempt, and try this in your attempt. You will get an idea that how, with what kind of paper is going to come. At last, but not the least, confidence is the key. Don't lose hope. Everybody lacks something. Nobody is prepared up to 100%. And don't do the mistake of leaving your attempt. At least attempt it. Everything is not in your hands. Leave it on God.